Today's news show is brought to you by The District on Kernan, where life happens.
Good evening, Ospreys. I'm Chelsea Kingsmill.
And I'm Rebecca Ely. Welcome to Osprey TV News.
Former UNF engineering professor Juma was fired after attacking a contractor at his home.
A bid was put in for his return, and after a thorough review, an arbitrator stood by UNF's decision to permanently fire him.
In other news, if you're interested in joining the intramural basketball team, there will be a meeting at 7 p.m. Monday, February 28th in the Student Union Building, 58 West, room 3804.
If this interests you, no experience is necessary, and it's great exercise too. If you have any questions, please call the number on your screen.
Since there will be many large campus events Saturday, February 26th, the UNF parking rules and regulations will be enforced on campus. This is excluding the housing parking lots from 9 a.m. to 3 p.m.
Each vehicle that enters campus must provide a valid UNF parking permit. There will be attendants in each parking lot and both garages who will be checking for valid UNF parking permits.
The attendants will be selling day passes to vehicles without a parking permit. For more information, contact Bill Dickinson at the number on your screen.
A talented artist has been creating spray paint works for students on the UNF campus. Andy Leverett reports.
A very unique artist has found his way to the UNF Green to entertain the students.
My name is Kurt Rentz. My artist name is Production. And I'm a spray paint artist out of Philadelphia. I've been doing this for a long time. Started off as a graffiti artist. Had to go from painting walls, from graffitiing on them, paying money and fines, to making money with the art that I learned when I was like six, I don't know.
What brought you to Jacksonville?
I painted here before, and it's like the first warm spot as soon as you hit Philly.
How many have you made today?
How many paintings have I made today?
Yeah.
Just two. I was just getting in the groove. The louder the music, the more the fans feel it, and the more the people feel it. The more I get into it, the faster I paint, the more creative the paint comes out. It's just that this ain't loud right now, so.
This is Andy Leverett reporting for Osprey TV.
Lee Moon and Dan Higgins spoke with Osprey TV about UNF getting a football team. Check out this exclusive report.
UNF-JU is such a natural rivalry anyway. It's a lot of fun in basketball and all the sports. So why not football? Yeah, I think UNF, you know, is facility rich anyway. It wouldn't take much for them to be playing ball, I don't think.
I think right now what you have to do is look at schools that are strong academic schools and how they have become recognized for basketball, because basketball has to be our bell cow, has to be men and women's basketball, has to be the standard bearer initially, and then comes baseball and volleyball and then men's and women's soccer. You've got to go down the list. But we need to really grow as a basketball program, because that's got to be our premier sport. The money it takes to invest in football is about $6 million.
Well, that's one of the great debates that I think it just depends on who you ask. Because if you ask I don't mean to dance around it, but if you ask the 20,000 who go to Gainesville every Saturday and the 15,000, 10,000, I don't know the number, I'm guessing numbers here, go to Tallahassee, they'd probably say college town, and some go to both. It's a football town, and I think that's the great thing about it. I mean, look at high school football. Look how many kids play football. Look how many kids go to college because of football. I mean, this area loves that game.
Are you a big country music fan? Well, if you are, there will be a Kenny Chesney Goin' Coastal Tour with special guests featuring Billy Currington and Uncle Cracker.
The tickets for the concert will be going on sale Friday, March 4th at 10 a.m. The concert will take place Thursday, May 12th at 7 p.m. at the Jacksonville Veterans Memorial Arena.
The ticket prices are $79.50, $59.50, and $25 plus applicable service charges. If you want to purchase tickets via phone, contact the number on your screen or go to Ticketmaster.com.
Blake Butler, author of Scorch Atlas and Ever, will be reading some of his work in the Student Union Building Friday at 7 p.m.
Butler will also participate in a question and answer session with members of the audience. The event is free and will be held in rooms 3703 and 3806.
The Greek Shipping Company will be permanently closing its doors this Friday, February 25th at 4 p.m.
Efforts are being made to find an alternative for the Greek shipping company.
Stamps can be purchased at the UNF bookstore. Outgoing mail that already has postage can be dropped off at Auxiliary Services located in Building 8, Room 1100.
Packages will be taken to the U.S. Post Office by the University Postal Services.
For more information, contact Auxiliary Services at the number on your screen.
Osprey TV was at the It's Time to Rock Your Image fashion show's dress rehearsal last night. We got some cool coverage of models walking on the runway. The fashion show It's Time to Rock Your Image will be hosted tonight. Here we have two interviews with representatives who are hosting the show and some shots of the models rocking the runway at the dress rehearsal.
It's Time to Rock Your Image is their give event where we're raising awareness, which is what a give event is, raising awareness about body image issues with today's youth. There is free food, free gift bags. It's for a good cause to raise awareness, and no one should miss out on this.
To raise awareness for body image issues in today's youth, that's kind of the mission statement for Chic, which is, you know, because like fashion isn't about being a size zero, it should be about wearing what makes you look good and all that jazz.
We will have more coverage later tonight at the show for the news on Tuesday, February 28th. This is Rebecca Ely reporting for Osprey TV News. We hope to see you tonight from 9 to 11 at the show in Building 58 West, Room 3703.
Well, Ospreys, that's all we have for you today.
We'll see you Tuesday.
Have a great weekend, Ospreys.